By the way, if my school are watching this, if you try sue me, try it. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I can get you arrested. Just try it and we'll see what happens. We love lip balm on this channel. Lip balm, boys. Let me hear you scream. Hello everyone, how are you doing? My name is Carmen and welcome back to my channel. What's good, boys? I hope you're having fun. The time is currently 1 in the morning. I'm lying, it's 11:30, but I still feel like it's 1 in the morning. It's super late and I don't know why I'm filming, but I kind of felt in the mood. I'm in a good mood and I don't get in a good mood often, so I thought it was a good time to film. Also, ignore the fact I look like I'm on drugs right now. I'm going through a bad stage where I've had a bad haircut, I've had a slit in my eyebrow, I fell in a bush. I'm having a bad time. I should probably end my life, but I'm still surviving. Never give up. Never be, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm also super sick, so if I sound like a whale, that's why. I have a cold, I have the flu, and I have a migraine, and I have a sore throat. I don't know what's going on, but I'm pretty sure I'm dying. I absolutely love it. I don't really care that much. I don't know why I'm telling you, but like, if I sound different, that's why. Anyway, let's get on with the video. And that, I saw on my Twitter, at touchdalight, go follow me or you'll get 10 years bad luck. I didn't make the rules, Jesus did. And I basically saw so many people talking about Jesus. I told you I was ill, I'm sorry. I basically saw so many people talking about GCSEs and it proper interested me. I love it when GCSEs come around because when I had my GCSEs a couple years ago, I was proper dying and felt sad inside. But it's chill, I'm over that now, you know what I mean? I'm happy, I'm not, I feel sad. But I thought it was a good idea to make a video about it as it's a trending topic so loads of you can see it and actually get a good idea of how to cheat in your exams. Like, I'm not even kidding. When I say I cheated in my GCSEs, I'm literally saying I cheated in my GCSEs. I got away with it, so I'm gonna tell you how I got away with it and hopefully you can do it too. Who cares about cheating in your exams? If you could cheat and get away with it, would you do it? Ooh, let me know in the comments. I'm not talking about cheating in relationships because that's bad. If you cheat in a relationship, you're bad and you deserve to not be happy. But cheating in exams, you already know I'm about to do it, boy. No one cares. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I'd rather get an A than an F, you know what I mean? Rocket science, leave me alone. Come on, guys, think about it wisely. So here's how someone like me, dumb as freaking, can't barely spell or read or write, got an A in most of my exams. Sit back and relax. Get a cup of tea and yeah, rock on, boys. If you are in school right now, make sure you hit the thumbs up button. I want to see how many thumbs up the video can get. I want to know how many of you are in education. And don't forget to comment down below what year you are in school. I'm super interested. Okay, so let's throw it back to 2 years ago when I was in year 11. Basically, I had a bunch of exams coming up. And in my uniform, I basically had a shirt, trousers, and a blazer. It was some ugly dark green blazer. No offense, no one looks good in dark green. Apart from me, I'm not gonna lie, I did look kinda cool. I didn't. I looked so bad. By the way, if my school are watching this, if you try sue me, try it. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I can get you arrested. Just try it and we'll see what happens. So I had a bunch of exams coming up and I was just super lazy and I really didn't have any energy to like revise and stuff. So I was sat in my room thinking about ways I could pass my exams without revising. Like, no offense, revising is so boring. Who wants to waste their time doing that? Absolutely no one. Let me hear you scream. I don't know what I'm screaming. I don't know who I am anymore. So I was trying to think of the best way to pass my exams and what came to mind was cheating. And I know loads of you are probably gonna hate on me and say, oh, but cheating's so bad, you shouldn't be cheating in exams, you're ruining the system. Like, no offense, shut your mouth, I don't care that much. Cheating is bad, but I'm telling you my story. I'm like, I mean, you can cheat as well, I'm not telling you to, but like, I still passed. A. So I sat in my room and I was like, I could spend my time revising or I could spend my time eating and having fun. I think you know which one I'm gonna pick, the eating and having fun one. You're right. So I dropped revising and threw that in the bin. So my exams were coming up and I didn't revise for any of them, so I knew nothing. It was super dumb, but I low-key didn't care. I'm kind of messed up. I can't tell if I look cool with my necklace out or in, can someone help me decide? I look dusty. So it came to my first exam. I can't remember what it was, but the only exam I remember properly cheating in was maths. The thing is, I kind of enjoyed maths, but I just wasn't very good at listening. I'm not very good at taking orders, do you know what I mean? So in exams, you can't actually have your mobile phone or anything in your pocket. But this is where my mind came in, because I'm low-key smart, you know how it is. I think the kids call it street smart, but that's none of my business. So how I cheated in all my exams was basically have a sheet of paper. I had loads of answers to questions I really did not understand and never probably will to this day. I had all the hard answers that I knew would be on the test, so I basically wrote them down on this piece of paper and shoved that in my pocket, but basically, in my blazer, I made a hole so I could sneak things in and then my teacher would literally check my blazer and find out I had nothing in my pocket. Just call me a king. I want to change my name to King Carmi now. I literally sound so dumb in this video. I can't wait to get a bunch of hate. I basically folded up this mini piece of paper. It was actually kind of big, but it's irrelevant. I shoved it all the way down my blazer, and because I had a hole in my blazer, the literal sheet of paper came to the very bottom. But if I needed it, I would literally be in my exam hall and sneak all the way in, grab it out, and put it on my desk. So I ended up sitting in the middle of the hall, so there weren't that many teachers around, because obviously in the hall when you're doing your exams, you have like loads of little teachers around you trying to make sure you don't cheat and stuff, and if you need any help, you can ask them. It makes sense, you know what I mean? If you're American, by the way, you probably don't understand what I'm talking about, but just listen to the story, it's fun. You might learn a few things. So I'm out here in my maths exam, struggling, writing all these answers and questions I've got no clue about, until it gets to the hard questions, and I'm literally rocking in my chair like, hey, I know what I'm about to do. In the exam paper, obviously all the questions are super easy at the start, and then when you get to page like 15, they start to get quite difficult. When it started getting hard, I got my paper out my pocket secretly so no one around me could see. I didn't trust any of my friends either, like I didn't want anyone knowing I was cheating. So I scrunched down, pick it out my pocket, and literally put it on my desk and open it, and basically put it on the page of the test so no one knew what I was looking at. I had the cheating paper here and my exam paper here, so I literally just basically copied everything. All the hard answers I didn't know, I had on the sheet, so I was literally copying it from word to word, and it was great. So that happened. I basically cheated through all my exams, and I passed, and that's basically how to cheat in your exam. If you are out there and you want to cheat in your exam, and you want to do it the way I've done it, if you get caught, do not blame me. Blame yourself. You're the dumb one for trying it, but you're also the smart one for trying, because you could get away with it and pass your exams and get a job in, I don't know, whatever you want to do and be smart. I don't know. Exams are boring. I actually only ended up doing this for my maths GCSE, but you can do this for your English, your Spanish, your history, your geography, like anything. And if there are any nerds out there and they're triggered by this video, I'm having some fun, you know what I mean? Like, take a chill pill. I'm not encouraging anyone to cheat in their exams. I'm literally just giving you a story about how I cheated in my exam. If you want to arrest me, arrest me. I literally don't care. Like, come to my house, I'll give you my address. But yeah, that's basically the time I cheated in my exams, and it was a fun time. I'm super successful now, I have depression and I hate my life. So make sure you subscribe for more quality content. That's basically it. If you did enjoy the video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up. And yeah, realistically, GCSEs don't mean shit in like later life. If you are a viewer of mine and you're doing GCSEs and you're stressing out, you're getting really upset over it, don't stress. I know you'll do amazing. Revise for your exams, be a good student, just have some fun and concentrate. I'm gonna stop being cringy and stop being annoying, but yeah, if you hate me, let me know in the comments, and that's basically it. Also, I have a bunch of new merch coming out on the 2nd of June. I have limited everything, so when it goes, it will go for a long time, so you really don't want to miss out on it. Like, honestly, it is so fire. I've got hoodies saying, go away. We've got hoodies saying, leave me alone. Like, they're so relatable. You're gonna want to get one. It's legit my favorite merch I've ever bought out, and I'm so proud of how it looks. It looks so dope. Like, I genuinely love it so much. Mark your calendars for the 2nd of June, and tweet me a picture knowing that you're ready, and that will make me happy. Follow me on my social medias if you want to know more about it. And that's basically it. I love you all so much, and I'll catch you in my next video. Stay safe. I don't know who I am, what I am. I'm gonna sleep. Bye. I'm actually really annoying. I don't know who I am.